Hello and welcome to this webinar. Today I will show you all the relevant functions regarding the topic data flows. As you surely know, certain application can quickly become very complex, and as a result, the overview of the data models in the SAP systems decreases very quickly. Today I would like to show you how the data flow functions of the Dooku Performer support you in managing complex data flows and give you a perfect overview so that your data models become more understandable for everyone. Okay, so first of all, I would like to introduce myself. My name is Alexander Kolmogortsev and I work as a product owner at Bluetelligence. I will guide you through this webinar today. Let's take a closer look at the agenda. So first of all, I would like to give you a theoretical overview regarding the topic data flows in SAP. And then I will answer some questions in the next 30 minutes. So first of all, how do I display the data flow of SAP BW and HANA? What functions can be executed to receive information regarding the data flow? How do I get a better overview of complex data flows? And how do I integrate data flows into my documentation? Okay, so let's start with the first question and with the theoretical part. So first of all, SAP systems and its data models are very complex and they are also subject of constant changes. And there are also many requirements from different areas like the business or auditors. These requirements usually require documentations and also an analysis of the current status of the subsystem. Graphical views of the data flow of a data model support you to meet these requirements. They are really helpful when it comes to clarifying connections and dependencies between objects and being able to see them at a glance. Graphical data flows also support you on the following use cases. For example, as you can see the first point, failure cause identification. So for example, if specific numbers in a report are not correct, it's important to be able to identify quickly from which sources the data in the report comes exactly. Then we have also the impact analysis. So before implementing, for example, change requests, it is helpful to have a complete overview of the object dependencies before changing anything. And last but not least, the question often arises from which sources reports get their data and what happens to the data along the way. It's really tricky to do this in SAP because the SAP standard functions are not really powerful. So it's really difficult to receive graphical data flows with the standard tools. The SAP tools don't provide you a view at a glance. So the different technologies are not connected with each other like BW, HANA and business objects, and also some specific information is nested and must be first identified manually. And it's pretty hard to do this with the SAP standard tools. It requires many clicks. And this is where Dooku Performer support you. So first of all, the data flow analysis are the central functions of the Dooku Performer and have been supported for a long time. We also improved in the recent years the data flow analysis more and more, and compared to the SAP standard, we offer more functionalities, and all in all, the functions helps the sub-users better understand their business analytics applications. So the benefits, first of all, it's faster IT response for questions and requests, it's a better traceability of changes within the system, a faster processing of requirements from the departments, and the last point, improved clarity, so you can identify the error much faster. Let's take a detailed look at which object types are supported by Dooku Performer. So on the left side, you can see, first of all, we start with the BW component. So you see on the left side that we support the data flow functions for the old BW objects like multi-provider InfoCubes DSOs. We also support the functions for the new BW for HANA object types like composite provider and RDSOs and for many other object types, as you can see, like for destinations, data sources and so on. You can open the data flows really quickly by using the context menu and click on display data flow. And after this, such a data flow will get generated by the Dooku Performer. You can do the same thing for the HANA component and for other object types like HANA repository views. Here we are supporting the object types, calculation view, attribute views, and analytical views, yes. And we support also the data definitions for ABAP CDS and the DIDIC views. Yes, so you can start the data flows also with the context menu, and then we generate such a view of your data flow. So the same is also possible for you, as I mentioned before, for the ABAP CDS data definitions. Okay, so let's take a look at the Doku Performer itself and how we can work with the data flow functions. So therefore, I will open the Doku Performer. And this is the initial view of the Doku Performer. Now I'd have the possibility, first of all, to select the relevant object type, for example, the data definitions. I can then search for a specific object, for example, this one, and just simply right-click on this object and click on Display Data Flow. Then Doku Performer generates such a view. So as you can see, we display the data flow of this data definition and also the used DIDIC tables. And now you can identify from which other objects and tables the data definition gets its data. You have also the possibility to display these layers. So if you're using a layer staging architecture, then it's really easy. You just click here on Show Assigned Layers, and then we display these layers. But first of all, you need to define them. These layers are based on some specific rules that you need to define first. Okay, so let's move to the next topic. For this purpose, I open the data flow of a multi-provider. So I switch the object type. And then I do the same for a multi-provider. So in this window, you can specify how the data flow should look like. So the Doku Performer can get access to the offline data, which we stored in our Doku Performer database, if you click here on offline, or you can also connect with your system in real time and generate an online data flow. If you want the data flow to open upwards, which makes sense for data sources, then you can just click here on upwards, and downwards makes sense for HANA Composite Provider or Multi-Provider, then you click on downwards. If the data flow is too complex, you can restrict it to a specific level, and you can do this here with this max level. So then you can also increase the overview. Okay, so I already opened the data flow here. So you can see now the data flow. So this is the first step. We can display the data flow of objects. We can do other things in this context. So for example, we can comment all the objects. As you might can see this little comment bubble, this means that this object was already commented in Doku Performer. So I can right click on this object, and then we see the comment of this info cube, for example. So we can store here technical information or business information. You can also comment your transformations. For example, yes, you can just right-click on a transformation, click on comments, and the same, you can just click on show comments. And a big advantage is if you comment this comment chapter, then we also display this comment within this data flow. I just need to find it. Yes, as you can see here, in this data flow view, we also display the comment of the transformation in this view. You can also execute some other functions. So from this context, you can just right-click on this info cube, go to analysis and execute, for example, a where used analysis. Then you can just check in where the info cube was used. So for example, in this multi-providers, in this HANA composite providers, and also in which process change it was used. You can also open the build-up of your object. So if you want to deep dive into the structure of a specific object, then you can just right-click once again on your object, go to analysis and click on analyze compare. Then you have this structure with all the elements of this info cube, so for the info objects, and also information regarding the DTPs. It is also possible to compare this info cube with another info cube from another system. Let's move back to the data flow. So now I have the possibility to add more helpful information to this data flow and perform some functions. So the first function I would like to execute, I already executed this function, is the ABAP lookup scan. So with the ABAP lookup scan, we check where does the information has been read from outside of the data flow. and the result is displayed in the transformation. So if we zoom in a little bit, then you see, for example, we have here a lookup from a table. Here we have also lookups from another DSO and also info object lookups. It is also possible to show the methods, as you can see here. The next function which I would like to execute is the DTP and info package analysis. Therefore, I click on this button and on this start DTP and info package analysis. So now the Dokio performer going through the transformation and detects which DTPs and info packages exist and in which process chains. It helps to find out why wrong data is shown in reports. So for example, if there is a filter on, for example, calendar year, which avoids that data from current year is loaded. If you try to identify this filter manually in BW, then you need to click every single DTP and check if the filter is there. With Dokio Performer, you see all the DTP filters at a glance, and then you can really easily identify the selections. So for example, here you see the selection on Euro. Yes, and for example, here also other selections, and as I mentioned before, the usage in process chains. Okay, I already mentioned the next function. It's the layer functionality. So as I mentioned before, you can show the layer. So the specific objects will be assigned automatically to the layer. In this case, for example, acquisition, all the DSOs, which starts, for example, with an A. And here we have, for example, also the data sources layer. It is also possible to display the queries and the reporting elements. So I can just right-click on Show Hide Reports, and then Dokio Performer shows which objects are based on this analyzed info provider, so on this multi-provider. So I can just simply click on these queries. And as you can also see, we display also Design Studio BO objects in this function. So we can also display analysis for Office, for example, or if this multi-provider was used as a data source in a Lumira report, then we also display these Lumira reports. In this example, I would like to click on these three queries, and I can also show the superordinated reports of this selected queries. I click on OK, and then we see the entire data flow at a glance. Yes, so you see we have here the reporting elements, the queries, and on this level we have the presentation layer, like web templates. You can also zoom out a little bit for a better overview. Okay, so as you might know, Dokio Performer opened two tabs. So this network view and also a tree view. So in this tree view, it's just another representation of the data flow. And here I can also execute some other functions. So for example, I can click on this function and then I can identify how many data records are available in the tables of the respective info providers. So you see the table name and also the number of rows. Or another function is process chains analysis. So I can click on this, and then DocuPerformer displays the process chains for the individual info providers, as you can see here. Yes, so now this is the right view. We see the technical name of this process chains and also the info provider of this process chains. Okay, so another really powerful function is, you can also find another really powerful function in this tree view. It's the mapping analysis. So for example, imagine your department complaining that the value in a report is incorrect. And what is then helpful is an overview of the mapping across the entire data flow. And exactly this information is provided by the Dokio Performer. So for example, you can click on this function and then you can select one info object. I will search for Nulcalde. I click on this and now Dokio Performer identifies how this info object zero calde is mapped over the entire data flow. So from which other info object or field does the info object obtain its data, and what is the respective source object? Is it a one-to-one mapping, or are data loaded from outside the data flow using start and end routines or other coding in specific transformations? So here you see the one-to-one mapping, and we also see that here, for example, we have a routine. And I can also, for example, here's start routine. I can also open the start routine and show the source code. So as you can see, if I click on start routine, then DocuPerformer displays also the start routine. Just a little hint, you can also execute this function for all info objects which are used in the multiprovider with the so-called data lineage function. This is another topic, and I recommend that you check out our YouTube channel. There you can find the data lineage webinar, and also you can find more information in our user manual. Now I would like to go back to the presentation. The next question, how do I get a better overview of complex data flows? And completeness is an important topic in the context of data flows. But at the same time, completeness can quickly lead to confusion in complex data flows, which is why we offer a new tool to solve this dilemma, the data flow views. So the data flow views are self-created objects in DocuPerformer, and they represent a subset of a complete data flow of an entity. So it improves the clarity for complex data flows, and if you execute analysis like I did before, then you can execute them faster because you only execute them for a subset of the data flow, not for the entire data flow. Additionally, from a business point of view, it might make sense to split your data flow into several data flow views. We will see this on the next slide. So here, for example, we have a data flow with the part provider contract management, backlog purchase, and purchase account assignment. And maybe it makes sense that we just create a data flow view for contract management, one data flow view for this part provider, another one for this one, and maybe a fourth one for the account assignment. So the big advantage, as I mentioned before, you can integrate these data flows also into your documentation, and then you have a better overview of the data flow. And this is what the function looks like in DocuPerformer. So you just open a data flow like I did before. You click on OK, and then you can exclude via the context menu the unneeded objects, exclude from this view. And maybe this path is also not relevant, and you can also exclude this path. Then you just click on Save Data Flow View, and then you can add the technical name for this data flow view and save it. So the big advantage is if you open the data flow once again of an object, then you can just select this specific data flow view, and DocuPerformer displays you only the relevant data flow. Okay, so the last question of this presentation, how do I integrate data flows into my documentations? So as I already mentioned, it is very difficult to document data flows because they change quickly and the documentation is therefore outdated. But DocuPerformer has a really nice solution for this problem. So first of all, it is possible to integrate the data flow, which I showed you before, into basic object documentation. And you can also assign objects of a data flow to a so-called scenario. And then you can decide for certain objects whether a graphical data flow should also be generated for the documentation and integrated also into the documentation. Okay, so as you can see in this image, it is also possible to select this pre-selected data flow views so that only this restricted data flow is considered for the documentation. So let me briefly explain what scenarios are. Well, scenarios allow the user to structure the documentation using text, image elements, and also Word files. Then you can also assign BW, BO, and HANA objects from different contexts to the scenario. If these scenarios are exported, the DocuPerformer creates technical documentation for each assigned object and combine this technical documentation with the existing documentation which you inserted into a scenario, with the comments of your objects, and also with these text elements and images you inserted before into the scenario. The result is a comprehensive documentation of the entire data model, for example. So let me show you once again within the DocuPerformer how you can create such a scenario and how you can assign objects to the scenario. Therefore, I reopen DocuPerformer, I close some of the tabs which I don't need anymore. And now, first of all, I will show you the scenario. So I created this scenario in advance, so I can double click on the scenario. And as you can see, I already inserted some text elements. So this text element represents later in the documentation a chapter. And you can add also content to this chapter. And now I would like to insert the objects of this data flow. To the scenario. So as you can see, I have this HANA composite provider. We see all the part provider, the data sources, and also the queries. What I can do now is I just select all the objects. I right click on the objects and then select the specific scenario. So which I showed you before. Or I go to scenario assignment and usage. Then I see all the created scenarios, PW and this one. Then I click on assign. I reopen the scenario once again. And on the right side, you already see that all objects were assigned to the scenario. So as you can see, all objects were assigned also to the right chapter. So because of the so-called assignment rules, it is possible to assign the objects automatically to the right chapter. So now you have the possibility to set some special settings for each info provider, for example. So for each info provider, you can decide whether you like to create a graphical data flow during the export. So you can just, for example, say, please show also the data flow layers, show also the comments of the transformations, which I showed you before, and also insert the results of a lookup analysis. You can decide this for each info provider in your scenario, and afterwards you can just click on export, and afterwards DocuPerformer connects with your SAP system and adds the technical information in real time into a Word file. And this is how, for example, this scenario of a data model could look like after the export. So first of all, you have a table of content. Here you also see some of the objects which were assigned, like the transformations. We see the comments of this mentioned text elements. So for example, an introduction, you can add images as I mentioned before. You can add, for example, also an entity list. So then it's good for an overview. So you know which entities were assigned to the scenario. And now you can see this graphical data flow, which were created during the export of the scenario. So in this case, the graphical data flow of this HANA composite provider. And then we have also the results of this ABAP scan, lookup scan, and some technical information regarding this HANA composite provider. As I demonstrated, it is really easy to create such a documentation of your data model. The export itself can also be started automatically, so that daily documentation is created in the background, and it is guaranteed that up-to-date documentation of the application is available. If you need more information about this, I recommend the webinar about the automation tool that you can also find in our YouTube channel. If functions or certain modules have been shown that you find really exciting and haven't licensed yet, you're welcome to contact us so we can do an individual webinar in which we can show you the function live. You can also test all functionalities of DocuPerformer for 60 days in a trial phase, so also the data flow functions for BW or HANA. And we are also always really pleased when we have the opportunity to present functions on site at your system so that you can see the advantages of DocuPerformer directly. Okay, just email us and we will then contact you. And this brings us to the end. I hope I was able to show you today the benefits of the DocuPerformer's Dataflow features. Thanks for your attention, and I hope to see you again at a future webinar. I wish you a nice day and goodbye.